good, T-Minus?
Niggas been counting me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading my clips, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. The real ones been dying, the fake ones is lit, the game is off balance, I'm back on my shit. The Bentley is dirty, my sneakers is dirty, but that's how I like it, you all on my dick.
Alright guys, welcome back to another Sole Sanity Sneaker Podcast. This is Season 2, Episode 5. I'm Spencer.
How you doing?
Alright, Eli, you want to start us off with a fit check?
You know, just the classic black and red Sole Sanity.
Give him a spin. Yeah.
Yeah. Nothing crazy with some...
throwback.
I think I'm pretty sure I've worn these pants on the podcast before. I
think you called them pistachio or something?
You know, something. And then, you know, the one and onlys.
Hey man, they don't look too bad.
No, they're actually not. I have taken a break from... I haven't been wearing them the whole time. I'll be truthful. I haven't worn them the whole time. Every day, but like 3 days.
Okay.
So yesterday I didn't wear them. St. Paddy's Day I didn't wear them. I wore the SB4s. And then there was another day I was just in a rush to work. And I put on some...
When did you get the 4s?
What?
The SB4s.
Like a month ago?
I don't remember that.
You remember that?
No.
Yeah, I traded for them.
What did you trade?
The white cement 3s.
I thought that was in the trade for the forces.
Which ones?
The green ones. Mm-mm. Yeah, I must have missed that.
No, the green ones was the Thunder 4s.
Oh.
And a bunch of, like...
miscellaneous stuff. Yeah, I just thought it was in that. Yeah, I thought it was in that. Well, I didn't know you had SB4s. Let me stop hanging so hard.
I wore those on St. Paddy's Day, and then one day I just wore white forces to work.
Did you take a picture of them on St. Patrick's Day? Okay.
No.
Three out of... Today's the 21st.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah. 18 days in, they still look pretty good.
They do.
Midsole's still white. Leather's not super creased. Mm-hmm. If you were wearing a crease protector, they'd probably be fine. So.
And I haven't, like... wiped them off or anything, like, and I haven't been dodging puddles or anything. I've been truly been walking in mud, walking in water, and even found myself on a basketball court day two in them, and my feet were not happy. But you know, it is what it is.
Yeah, they do look pretty good. I told myself I was gonna wear them a lot closer to the release date, but obviously it's Air Max month, so I've been true to what I didn't tell anybody I was going to do it, but I started on day three, so I'm 3 days behind, so my Air Max month will leak into April a little bit. But yeah, I've been trying to wear Air Max all month.
Your feet are feeling better than mine.
I'm not hurting too bad. I won't go anywhere today, probably, so I have these. I've worn these before, Air Max 2 Light. It's like a USA collab. I got these from Jimmy Jazz. They look like they'd be something that you couldn't get at a retailer.
Right.
USA t-shirt and some Levi's jeans. You see this, like, I've only worn them once, and they got this, like, this is not a stain. I think this is just aging, which is so weird, because it's not, like, this is, like...
not a super old shoe, but...
it's not super old. I probably got it 3 or 4 years ago, but, like, I don't even know what to call this material. It's almost like nylon.
Yeah.
And why is it, like, turning colors, you know? That's weird, but that's me today.
So we're not going to talk about how the gold watch matches
I mean, I wouldn't try to, you know... my favorite part of the shoe is just little, like, plaid inside things.
Yeah, that's nice. Plaid, and then I like the USA on there, too.
Oh, I'm a sucker for anything that replaces, like, where the Nike stuff is supposed to be. Sucker.
Yeah.
For sure. You know. All right, Eli, you want to talk about the INDIE 500? Your mans? My mans?
I mean, what's first thoughts? Just the little leak video that we seen?
They look like the old Dreamers. Plus, like, a 500, like, an easy 500, in my opinion. If I'm a, like, bring it out just for... It looks like he took this, and, like, put them together.
Yeah.
Because they're, like, basketball shoes still. And, I mean, he still got the cloud on the back and everything. Yeah. But he added the zigzag material, like, pattern on it. But in my opinion, it just looked like he took these two shoes and kind of, like,
and just
mixed them together. Yeah. Obviously, that's not exactly what happened, but Like, those are the inspirations I see when I look at the shoe.
It almost reminds me of, like, a, Cole's known for wearing, like weird designer, too, mm-hmm. almost, like, on stage, and, like, the baggy look is, like, I mean, he's been wearing baggy stuff for a long time now. It almost reminds me of, like a high-end, like, Balenciaga, too, like, that's all kind of crazy designs and everything like that and crazy colors, but, I mean, they're cool. I want to see, like, an actual in-person, like, picture of them and see them. I'll probably buy them just to collect them just because we're cold people, so.
I just hope they're affordable. Let's go for about $100, Cole.
Yeah.
You know, I can give me, like, 3 pairs. I can hoop in one. I can wear one. I can have one to just keep on the shelf. I'll take all different colors or whatever, you know what I'm saying? I like the green one that they showed. Speaking of Dreamville and designers, you see Jid is the new, he's like a brand ambassador for Lacoste now. They like released a shoe for him and everything.
I didn't see that.
And he's got a whole like line. So he's basically like one of their like models now. So
sick.
Just shout out my man.
I didn't see that.
Jid.
I didn't see
it. And then you sent me yesterday the loot with
the champion.
So I'm excited to see that too.
This is usually the time of year where Dreamville gets to to cook, obviously because the festival. But a lot of stuff that, you know, we might not get eight months out of the year. Usually within these four, they go crazy going into summertime. So
you think we'll see some Dreamville champion stuff at the festival?
I would assume so.
Let's hope so.
I would assume that it was either hype for they were building that hype up for that or like the pop up shop that we went to.
Pop up would be cool.
So
maybe I get picked to work.
Sheesh. That'd be insane.
I'm gonna have to put in some PTO for that. But, you know.
It is what it is.
Yeah, I gotta do what I gotta do. So overall I'm pretty excited for the I'm just excited in general for the whole might delete later. Like all of that just like
so hard.
Just gives you a feeling. Like
the amp up of not knowing the unknown of like what the music could be and stuff like that. So
the commercial was crazy. The commercial was so hard.
He's been killing it with the vlogs lately. Mm-hmm. So I don't know who he's been tapping in with or who's taking his videos, but they've been doing their thing.
Yeah. His production team, like they make it look so real. Like, I mean, I know it is real, but like obviously they know there's cameras on at the same time. So like they make it look like there's not, like they didn't know there was cameras there. It's crazy. Or maybe they're just good actors. I don't know, but they surprise me every time.
Well, I feel like when you're like in that space, like and you're that popular or that famous, like I would assume you get used to just the cameras being in your face. So
at all times,
you know, you gotta act yourself. So, what else?
I do want to say though, I said this to Rick. I really wish, like. I'm glad that he's doing his own brand, you know, because he's making his own money.
Right.
But I really wish he would have, like, signed with, like, Jordan. And maybe he wants to. Maybe Jordan's not in on it. You know what I'm saying? But, like, at one point, that's all he was wearing. And, like, that would be such, like, an organic, like, collaboration. And he's so popular. Like, I don't understand, like, where the disconnect is. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They can pick up Drake and Travis Scott and whatever. But, like,
yeah. You know. I mean, that'd be a dream collab. I was about to say something crazy. I was going to say they could put it on a Team Jordan. I'd probably buy it, but...
I mean, if they put it on the right one, I'd probably buy it, you know? But just imagine, like, we get, like, four seal drive Jordan 1s because they're, like, you know, like, that's what he was on the cover, or, like, the Sideline Story 7s or something. That'd be crazy. Yeah.
And I didn't realize he wore the Jordan 1 high, the Chicago's.
Mm-hmm.
All the time because he was born in 1985 and that's when that shoe came out. Just like shit like that, you'd be like, what the
fuck? Yeah, like it's crazy. So like that's like, and like his logo is like basically almost made to look kind of like the Jordan logo. And so like imagine having the Dreamer logo,
more like the Wings logo or where the Wings logo.
Well, like
was.
His Jumpman where the Jumpman should be. That'd be crazy.
Yeah.
The little
That would
be crazy.
That would be it. I was going to say the Dreamer, like the cloud.
Oh, the cloud where the wings. Yeah, I mean, either way, or the cloud where the Nike Air would be on like some threes or something like that. there's endless possibilities, Jordan Brand. Get on board. And Jermaine, get on board.
That's all we can say.
Jermaine Lamar. Yeah, I'm tired.
I'm tired of you, bro.
You're stressing me out, man.
Tired of you, bro. I love you, bro. I'm tired of you.
And don't retire. Speaking of threes.
The Black Cement threes are not getting reimagined.
How do you feel?
I mean, I like it. More of the OG.
I'm all for it. Yeah. I don't have a like any Black Cement threes, so I would rather have the original than a copy or a, not a fake, but you know, like a remaster.
Yeah.
The original is always gonna beat that. Like I don't need an aged pair or a suede pair or anything.
No.
I'll just take the regular one. Yeah. You know.
Not on that one. I think they've kind of heard what the people say about the Reimagine series, like we've talked about with, you know, suede on the Royals or the satin breads and the patent breads and stuff like that. I feel like there's some people that really love them, there's some people that really don't like it, and then there's people in the middle. So I don't know if they just thought that they didn't want to mess up a classic like this and give us the actual thing, but I don't know. I'm sure they had the same feeling about the White Cement 3 too, but I'm trying to figure out what to say. Like, they were willing to take a chance on the White Cement because of, like, the white and the aging more than the black, I guess you could say. Or they might have made pairs and there was, like, we don't like how the way it looks because it looks more like a brown on the sole, but I'll take a Black Cement 3 any day.
And, like, I'm not saying that the White Cement Reimagined is, like, a bad shoe or anything. I'll take it, but I'm always going to want an original over the Reimagined. So, same thing with the Lost and Founds. I would much rather have had a regular pair of Chicago's. I can age them myself. I can wear them, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
I don't need them to come pre-aged at all. There's a women's three that came out within the last 2 years that almost looks exactly like that, except it has a gold trim. But the midsole is like, I mean, it's not brown, but it's like aged, you know?
Yeah.
So.
You talking about the one that has the gold tone?
Yeah, gold, yeah. It's basically Black Cement with age with gold, like, you know? So, we already got that, you know? We didn't...
I remember selling that shoe. That shoe was...
Bam. We up until, like, a few weeks ago, we had one in the store sitting. But to the point where it was on sale. Don't make no sense, man.
Oh, the First in Flight Jordan 1s.
First in Flight Jordan 1s. I'm gonna let you speak first.
I just like the idea and the color blocking, and then with the gold accents on it. I think it's confirmed that it's a women's one.
Yeah, women's release, no extended size.
Yeah. I mean, I'm good on that, because that, you know, I can fit in that, but, I don't know, I was thinking about on the way here, because I was like, on the podcast, I've been like, pull the lever on Jordan 1s, pull the lever on Jordan 1s, like, just stop producing them because they're flooding the market so much with them. And this is actually one that I was like, okay, I actually like this.
I like it, but this is one that I'm glad that they did not do extended sizing on, because I feel like it would be wasted. I don't think enough of the big feet people are going to want it. It's not a bad colorway. It reminds me of the Starfish blocking with like a obsidian vibe. The best part about this shoe is the insole.
For sure.
If they do like some premium materials on it as well, like maybe some gold aglets, lace tips, you know, like that'll make this shoe better. But this is one that the ladies can have. I might change my mind if I can get them at, you know, less than retail, but as of right now, I think I'm good.
I hope we talk about the Jordan 1 boxes. I hope the box is kind of cool on that. Like, I hope we don't get a...
You're getting one of those, buddy.
Yeah.
You're getting one of those. I'm going to go ahead and tell you right now, you're getting one of those,
buddy.
Yeah,
you know, it'd just be cool to dream of, but yeah, probably just get the red box. But I do want to see them in person as well. But I do like the light blue and the dark blue, and then with the gold accents and everything. So I'm excited for it. I mean, we'll see what it looks like in person.
Because since today's the 21st, I wanted to show these since I have them.
Yeah.
You already should know. these do release Saturday, the 23rd. Powder Blue, Jordan 9. I've been waiting on this one. History lesson, I guess. Me and Eli went back and forth about this little missing 23 right here on the back. Turns out, neither one of us knew what we were talking about. The last pair came out in 2010. Now I had a black stitch 23 right here. And a lot of the images, when you look up, you know, that's the first one you see. Because you're not going to see a lot of pictures from the original.
From the OG one.
So, in 1984, when they came out, 84, 85, something like, not 85. 85. Not 85. 95. 90, 90,
okay.
Yeah,
94. 94,
95, whatever.
Okay. I was about to say, we just.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It didn't sound right when I said 8, but I said 94 first. Okay. It did not have it. So, this is as close to the OG as we're probably going to get. And for that reason, after the turmoil, this is a cop. If you don't know already, this is a cop. This is the nice. One of the best nines coming out this year. I don't know if I can put it over the olive, but the olive is.
People have been asking about these too. We've already took like, we've taken pre-orders already for these. So, I think they don't really release a lot of nines, mm-hmm. and then when they do, people enjoy them.
Yeah.
And then with it being actually close to the OG one,
this is definitely a good one.
Let me see. Yeah. Yeah, it's a good one. Yeah. So, I think when they actually do a nine the right way and people ask about them, then I mean it sells.
I don't get a lot of chances to get nines just because they don't release a lot of nines. So this is a no brainer for me. Yeah. Now I just got to figure out how to pay for it. I'm taking donations.
For sure. But yeah, no, this is a clean shoe for sure. I want to see what the olives look like, though. I'm excited for those. Because I've always wanted a pair of those. So.
The olives are going to be crazy.
Alright.
So we'll start the series, of the unboxing series. So I got a couple votes yesterday, but nobody agreed on anything. So I went my own route with something that I felt like had a little bit of substance, would take up a little bit of time. But it might take up too much time, so this might be two parts. I'm going to start with my Nike SB Dunk collection. If we have enough time, then I'm going to do my regular Dunk collection as well. But I'm going to start here as well because of something I got in the mail yesterday. So, you know, I'm real excited to debut these. Can you slide me the first box, please? You can throw me that pink box, actually.
We're here, I thought it to me.
Okay. I'll do one, you do one.
Okay.
Cool. So, and I'm not going to know the names of all these, so this is just not going
to,
you know.
I'm not expecting to know the names of them either.
You know, I'm going to do a date, I'm going to give them a name myself, and then we'll move on. We'll keep going. Not all of these are worn by me. I bought these pre-owned in 2021. The release date on, not the release date, but the manufacture date on this is 03/05. So, March of 05. I have not worn these, but they were skated by somebody I used to work with. He said he told me he was a professional skater. I hope that was true. I'm going to call these the Cinco de Mayo.
I was about to say Mexico City.
They had yellow laces, but I wouldn't put those in my ray gun. So.
Those are nice. It reminds me of almost like how they do like the Heineken colorways too.
I probably should wear these on Cinco de Mayo or something like that, but you know. Well, I have a chance. I have a chance this year. Okay, cool. Next. Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Okay. So this is not a dunk. This just was in that SB box. So this is the Nike Zoom FC. So this is the Juventus colorway. It's a soccer shoe. This also, the date on this one is 04. 04/04. So March. This is a 20-year-old shoe.
These are kind of crazy.
April. Oh, yeah, April.
The back of it?
Yeah, Juventus tag on it. That's crazy. This is a 20-year-old shoe at this point. I'm pulling it pretty hard, so this is pretty sturdy. I mean, maybe if I wore it, it might change, but We don't see a lot of stuff like this like come out from Nike anymore. You don't. I haven't worn these either, but that's just because they're kind of all already worn anyway, yeah. Kind of beat. So,
not the shoe I was expecting to see.
I'll let you go again. You didn't get a real SB. All
right,
next.
Okay, black box.
That should be an SB.
I don't think I've seen this one.
Lima bean laces.
This one's nice. The Carolina blue with the lime green.
With the paisley on the back.
Yeah, it's hard. I like this one.
It's got the embroidery across the stitching too, as well.
Yeah, this one's nice. What is this?
Yeah, you gotta get behind that strap.
2005?
Yep. 19-year-old SB Dunk. No. No separation.
What would you name these?
Pistachio. Pistachio, lima bean. Is blue an Easter color?
Yeah. This color?
Yeah. So the Easter dinner. You know, we got the lima beans and the okay. If you want some pistachios, you get some. Those go with your pants. There you go. You know what I'm saying?
8.5. Whoa.
It's actually a 9. Okay. Not all the boxes match.
I was about to start.
Dang. So the reason I have all these old SBs, I bought 17 pair for $400 from that professional skater dude who worked at my Dick's Sporting Goods. So shout out my boy. I also bought those Air Force Ones that I have for my boy at the same time. So I spent $800 and got 35 to 40 shoes.
You were going crazy that day.
Yeah, I was lit.
Going insane.
Hey, next.
Producer.
Okay, so mids. We don't see mids a lot.
You don't see mid dunks or mid SBs.
Yeah, not a whole lot. I don't see mid dunks regularly. Yeah. So anyway.
This takes me back to like my middle school, like early high school days almost.
I think this pair retroed recently.
Like when the. Was it just me or when everybody went to high school? Everybody went to like Vans and Converses and stuff like that.
I feel like people were wearing Vans when we were in middle school, but Converse is more in high school and after that. Because Comme des Garçons was real big when we were in high school.
Yeah.
So the production dates on these are 1106 to 107. So.
I feel like I've seen this model, maybe not this particular shoe, but this model like growing up in middle school or high school for sure.
This might be a Dreamville shoe. I've never worn it. So, you know, so I can still undies something and not worry about completely tearing it to shreds because it's already kind of beat.
Yeah.
I should have some comfort still, you know, with the padding and everything. And it's black, so.
When we're in the mosh pit.
Yeah.
Oh, stink! I'm ready for the mosh pit.
Nah, you're not ready. Not ready. It's not fun. Oh, yeah, it's him.
It's me. Thank you. We have another mid. This one's kind of crazy.
Supreme? Yeah. You can call it Supreme?
Supreme is.
Supreme is.
The laces are crazy.
The embroidered SB? With the cursive writing? Embroidered SB? Crazy.
Yeah, the details on these. These are insane. Oh, these fat laces, dude. I mean, this is like real, real skater vibe for real. Like, they were definitely. Nike SB was making these to skate in, no doubt. Like, they weren't thinking about nothing else. We're making these for you to skate. What is it? 08.
That's a 6.
Is it? Oh. The back?
Oh, what?
I'm tweaking.
Unless okay.
No, I'm tweaking. It's a 6.
So six. Do the. Oh, never mind. I thought this whole strap came off. I was about to say, I've never seen that before. It's crazy.
That's insane.
Yeah, so the Supreme.
Supreme.
Mids.
Supreme mids.
I don't know what we gave the black mid. Black mids.
The everydayers.
Yeah.
Another mid.
I really like this one. I had to salvage this one because it was in my... when I moved out of my last apartment, I basically didn't stay there for a while. And when I came back to some of my shoes, they had mold on them. So I had to spray them with vinegar and like wipe them all down. But I had to salvage this one. But
I like this one. It's like a...
Smoke gray.
Yeah. Well, it reminds me of that that like all silver Japan Jordan 1 that they came out with.
That's what I'm reminded.
That one and the other, I think it's called Smoke Gray, but it has a red tongue.
Yeah.
Yeah.
2006 again. Holy shit.
I want to wear these. I was upset when I came back, but they're salvaged for the most part. I think they're still wearable. None of these are in bad condition. None of the soles are separated or anything like that. So not no crumbling. Either. Now there's one in there that I'm scared to look in the box. It's actually not an SB, so we'll see.
Now, was the guy wearing these, like, over time?
I don't think so, bro.
Or, like, once he got done, like, skating and was out of it, he was just out of it?
Yeah, he was just done. He was the golf lead at my Dick's Sporting Goods, so he was just, I don't know. I had never seen him wear anything but dress shoes and stuff like that, and golf shoes. Next.
Pink box. Heater.
Yeah.
Heater.
I don't know what I was gonna say. This was probably like one of the best pairs in my collection. Yeah.
The Ray Gun.
These are those yellow laces that I was talking about from the Cinco de Mayo. These are crazy.
These are so nice.
I wish I had both pair. Roswell Ray Gun on there, man. That's just, these are fire.
And the thing is, like, Nike always seems to, like, come back with, like, Ray Gun stuff. Mm-hmm. Is it every year? Or is it, like, kind of once every couple
years? Once every couple years, I would say. But they did, the Dunks.
Yeah, we did. But when we were at Hibbett, they did, like, the Blazers and stuff like that. Yeah,
I think there's Air Force Ones.
Yeah.
I think I have the Blazers.
And, like, even the merch that they do and everything like that, like, that type of stuff makes me want to buy it just because of this shoe.
Yeah.
Because of how dope, like, this one was.
I wish I had the white one, too, though.
Yeah. These are so crazy. This is a SB that I would definitely buy and have in my collection.
Unfortunately, within the last year, I did have two more SBs. I had the Mork and Mindy Highs, which is the red and silver ones, and I had the Bic, which is like a yellow and black one. I couldn't fit either one of those. I tried all these on to make sure I could fit them because some of these are varying sizes. I wasn't able to fit either of those, so I did end up selling those. But I kind of wish I would have kept them just as pieces, but I got different shoes. So, I mean, you know, it was worth it at the time. Next.
Saving that 3-pack for last.
Yeah, we'll get there. You know, be able to slide that one. So, I took the green lace out of this one for that. This one, these are Beat. I don't know if that's, I don't know if this is a drink he spilled on there. I don't know if that's blood. I don't know what it is. But yeah, this one got worked.
That one's cool.
We can call these the Celtics.
Yeah.
You know.
This reminds me of the Dunks they've been coming out with.
Yeah, the Dunk is probably this exact. Well, this one's called White Classic Green.
Yeah.
The one that's out right now it's like Malkite.
Yeah.
But there's an Air Force One right now that's like that, and then there's a Dunk like that as well.
Well, they did all the Dunks like the, they did like this color block and the all white with like orange swoosh and orange bottom and like that dark that Hyper Royal where it's all white with the dark blue check and the dark blue sole. So
these are 04. This is another 20-year old shoe. We didn't even check the Ray Guns. I don't know what the date is on the Ray Guns.
I would say 06.
That's probably a good guess. Jeez. 04. Another 20-year-old shoe.
Insane.
20-year anniversary for the Dunks. Next.
I hope I get my favorite one out of three. Okay.
Another.
I've been getting all the soccer shoes.
Another non. It's an SB shoe, but it is not a Dunk. So this is another Zoom FC.
This one's
really cool. I'd probably wear this one before I wore the Juventus one. This one's also in good condition, no separation of the sole or anything like that.
This reminds me of the D book.
Oh yeah.
Almost.
The
chunky, like the way the tongue looks like from the top down. So.
Bye. I could wear these to Dolphins game. Wear these, you know, Dolphins jersey and stuff like that, you know.
Yeah. Does it have a production? 2000? No way.
No, that says 05.
Okay, I was about to tweet.
Yeah, 05.
But yeah, that's the first thing that reminded me of when I seen it.
It does look like the book now that you said that, though.
Maybe book had inspiration from these.
Maybe. He wouldn't tell us. No, give it to Eli.
Okay.
That's a good one right there, though. We're starting to see the different Aero boxes. This is probably one of the most expensive shoes in my collection, even with this little snag on the front. I've actually wore the dog shit out of these. Not dog shit, but I used to wear these pretty often. This is the Reese Forbes Nike SB Dunk Low.
Yeah, these are... This inside on these two, the...
Quilted?
Yeah.
Yeah, these are nice. With the actual burlap on the toe and on the side. I love these. Even used, these are worth like a stupid amount of money.
Yeah,
I think brand new, they're like $1,500 or something.
If you ever want to get rid of a...
Well, sir, this is a 10 and a half.
No. Not for me. I was saying, I've recently joined a SB Collectors like Facebook group, so... To reach your top dollar.
Make sure you send this video in the chat.
Yeah, for sure. So, we can get that going. Into the SBs.
2004.
Insane.
Yeah, this is a good one. This is probably one of my favorite ones that I own.
Yeah, it's so nice.
I'm not, I don't own any of those camo pants like everybody else has, but if I did, it would go stupid.
Those would
go stupid.
Oh, it's a newer box.
Yep, I got this one, not this Christmas, last Christmas.
I did not know you had these.
Yes, you did, bro. And I added the pink laces. I haven't worn them since I've added the pink laces. I wore them once around that Christmas. They're a little too small. They're a 9. But I took the insole out. That made it a little better. Even though that got rid of the Zoom like cushion here. But the Sandy Bodecker. The Nike SB Man. eBay Dunks. I like my little lace swap.
I've been looking at these at the store, I'm not going to lie, for the summertime.
Nah, not a summer shoe, my dude.
Not a summer
shoe. Not a summer shoe, my dude. These joints fog up so bad.
Maybe not.
Yeah, not a summer shoe. But, I mean, you You can try it.
Summertime, no socks?
Yeah, I mean, hey, that's what the insole dude is doing.
I mean, I don't see a problem.
Hey. This one's like a staple. I'm really glad they brought it back. I think they could have done a little better on the ventilation or something like that, though. But just a cool one to have. It says SB on the back instead of Nike SB, though. That's pretty cool, too. I love the color blocking on this, though. I got these laces out of the Travis
logo. Yeah. It's a unique shoe, for sure.
Yeah. Love this one. My first tri-colored box like that, too.
It's another soccer shoe.
Nah, I only got two of those.
The mids?
Yeah, mid, tie-dye.
Tie-dye denim?
Yeah, tie-dye denim. I really fuck with these. These laces are crazy. I actually had a pair of rainbow laces just like this, and I put these in my Roshi runs in middle school. I gotta find a picture of that and add it.
Not the Roshi runs?
Yeah, Roshi runs in my Elite socks. I thought I was the man.
Everybody did. Yeah, these are nice too. The denim with the... I think I said
'08. So I still got some life in these. The tie down on this is crazy though.
The thing
like,
is,
like even
is
on
like,
the inside.
The thing is, like you can like, you see like this type of stuff, and you're like '08. Like you can just imagine, like for me, like you can imagine what the outfits were looking like back then with those on, and like, just
you get some jean shorts with this, some big jean shorts, bro. John Cena.
Yeah. With a crazy jersey.
Yeah.
Is it you?
Spence. This a newer box or?
This is a newer box. I've had these for three or four years though. The Spectrum High Dunks. I got these for retail. I've only worn them once. I wore them one Thanksgiving. But I'm a fan of these like color blocking. This is also like an Easter kind of shoe.
I was about to say the same thing about the low top ones.
Pistachio kind of. Dang. So this one's got like the flipped blocking. This one is.
Oh, I didn't even notice that.
Yeah. Blue versus the green and red. But I'm a fan of this shoe. I need to wear it more.
These are nice.
As you can see, like the bottom is still crispy. I wore these like at my like home Easter function or something, you know, or Thanksgiving is what it was. This one reminds me of the Turduncan a lot, which is one I still want. I'm just waiting for the price of the special box to go down. This was probably one of my first pairs of SBs. There's a lot of skate shops in Wilmington that were easy to access, so I don't think I paid an arm and a leg for these. And I'm also a really big fan of high top dunks. I probably like highs more than I like lows, to be honest.
I like that.
Because everybody, like, doesn't like highs. Yeah. Which is so weird because everybody likes Jordan 1 highs and doesn't like lows.
It's the same way with, like...
Stupid. But it's stupid that it's reversed and they're the same fucking shoe, dude.
Yeah, it is.
Shit blows me. Yeah. You're giving me a rant. Next.
Get off his chest today.
I got time. I'm off today. Ooh, I got time.
These are nice.
I got these last year from one of my homies. This is a Zoom SB, so the tongue is a little bit thinner. There's a Zoom pocket in here.
Yeah, I like these.
Orange things. Pulse is something.
I was going to say, it reminds me of the, not like a Curry Dunk, but like,
yeah,
I feel like that type of colorway, you know what I mean?
It's
like,
almost Longhorns,
yeah,
like color. These are fire though. Nice. This is a 2017 pair, so this one's not super old. I wore these quite a bit last year. If I can get some like sale colored SB laces, yeah, that would go stupid.
These are nice.
Or even brown or something like that.
I had somebody actually in the store the other day asking me about, because they did the Dunk SB with the thin tongue with those N7s.
Yeah.
The white pair with the black and the white pair with the red. So somebody was asking me why it said Nike SB in the thin. So I had to.
Those are the ones Pastor got, right?
Yeah.
With the Paisley, the Day of the Dead joints.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Had to give him a little history lesson on it. So.
Look here, buddy.
So. But like, I would say like that's like my favorite part of the job is like when people truly don't know and they're asking questions because they want to know.
Yeah.
So like, and it gives you time to be educated about it.
Yeah, it's cool dropping knowledge on people sometimes. Another pair of mids.
This almost look like a low when
this one says white, black, bone, so bone.
This almost look like a low when you pulled it out with a strap on it.
It looks small, for sure. Let's look at this. 06, 07, so like the end of 2006. I like these with the little red stitching on the tongue.
I was about to say the same thing.
On the swoosh. It's a nice detail. It reminds me of the lottery dunks, the gray ones that came out. I don't think these wear away though. I think they'd be gone by now. I think he would have did his thing.
These are nice. A good neutral color too.
Yeah. Still no separation on any of these. So that's good. I just need to take some time to wear them. Need to designate a dunk month next, I guess.
Sheesh.
Pink box.
I really like those.
Yeah, these are
high, all suede. I think I took the laces out to clean them. Did.
Yeah. Come with the red and the white laces.
Yeah, this is a good one. This might be a Dreamville shoe for real, because I like highs better than anything. And the fact that it's all suede.
Yeah.
I'm loving that. The gray accents are cool too.
And all black. All black with the red laces would be insane. Holy. '05.
Yep. January 05. Almost 20 years.
Shit.
Clean. The reason I like Dunk High is because of the tongue.
Yeah.
Like, and how it comes up past the shoe.
I was about to say the same thing. And how they sit too. I like that.
Classic.
Yeah, these come with the white and the...
Classic.
Would you put the white or the red laces in?
Probably do red. Probably do red. Both shoes.
Whole lot.
I'm not a white.
Whole lot of red.
All right.
Number one.
Got these in the mail yesterday. First and foremost, the Buttercup. Where'd the extra laces go?
They're in here.
Oh, okay. I was about to say.
I just seen them. No, I took them in there.
Okay. My favorite part about like these, this pack, is that like all of them have a different like theme to it. So like this one's like patent, like shiny,
like material,
like a matte almost.
Yeah.
I love the fact that all of them have black laces though.
For sure.
I think they would look so much better than white if they came with white. But these are crazy. Like all of these are crazy.
You've been wanting these for a while, so.
Yeah, and I just had to settle. Like they didn't go down in 3 months. I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna bite the bullet.
I think. Buying them now and having the pack early on is going to be a good financial decision because I do see these going up, especially as more people wear them.
Yeah.
And the brand new pairs are going to
dwindle
over time, dwindle down. So if you try to wait a couple years and get the whole pack, I think you'll just be like, you might as well just get them now like you did.
They took forever to get here, dude. Yeah.
I want to say that this is probably my favorite one out of the pack.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Me seeing the green and the other ones, I don't know what it is about all green shoes lately, but I do think that's my favorite one out of the pack.
Not a lot of people say that. People say this is the worst one. I was going to ask you where you ranked it. I can't put any of them in order.
Yeah.
I don't have a favorite. I love this, though. These are fire. Jeez. Oh my gosh.
We'll put that. We'll make that a real content.
Yeah.
Make that real.
So this one is fire. Like, it's like marble almost.
Yeah.
And this.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like that hard. None of the other ones got that.
No, they don't.
That's crazy. These with black laces though is gonna look fire. But the orange is fire too. But pink,
it's gonna be hard.
Pink would be crazy too, cause it came with black, right? Yeah. Okay. Yeah, it's in there. Black with this.
Yeah.
Is gonna. Yeah. I don't know, but I wish they would have came with pink too. But yeah. All of this is.
I think
fire.
If you do the black laces, that'll make this orange stand out, like pop a little bit more too. So, but yeah, these are. I want to say these are vice. We'll have to wait till the other ones.
Okay.
But I want to say this is probably my number two.
Okay.
I
don't know, brother. You got it. That blue one is crazy,
yeah,
bro. The inside of all of these, like the satin.
And details, the satin, the eyes. Like, this is a shoe that we kept in, or that we try to keep in store. And, this is a shoe we try to keep in store. But they're really hard to, really people don't want to sell them.
Yeah.
And, you know, unless they get a certain number. But it's always a good shoe to have for us in store because it's a shoe that people won't want to see in person. So they want to see the material. They want to feel the satin. I have nothing bad to say about this. Like we said, like, even from when they first leaked down, we did an episode, like, just the nostalgic of, like, the 2000s and, like, us growing up, like, with this, like, growing, like, just the cartoons and, like, just stuff people can resonate with and actually be, like, a dope collab and, like, the shoe's actually hard. Like, I don't think they maybe could have done something else, but honestly, like, off the top of my head, I couldn't tell you what they could have done different to make the shoe better.
The only thing that I think could make this pack better is if they did the extra one.
The purple one?
Yeah, that would
be. I'm not gonna lie to you. If they would have done the purple one would have been number one for me.
Yeah, no, the purple one would have been crazy.
And then the paper would have been just him on it.
Even if they did him on the insole like they talked about.
Yeah.
Let me not mix up these boxes. That would have been fire. That would be crazy.
Last but certainly not least.
Who did it last? I did. You go.
Yeah. Wait. Oh. It's me or him?
Oh yeah. You just hit him in the face.
Yeah.
Like the bubbles on there though. That's
what
crazy.
I'm saying. Like
that's crazy.
That's why I'm like. I want to put the pink one in, but the details on this one with the bubbles and like the material's different on this one too. Like.
The yellow laces is crazy too.
Yeah.
I can't pick. These are
insane. No, they're super nice. I still think this is my order though, green. Well, green's definitely one, but I keep going back and forth between blue and pink being number one or number two. Because, like, I want to put this because of the materials and the bubbles and, like, just a little bit more details. But the pink is just, like, literally insane.
I think if all of them would have had a thing,
yeah,
then, like, the pink wouldn't be as, like, hard to argue for. Like, this one could have had a circle for a bubble, and this one could have had a blossom for, a flower.
Yeah.
And I think that would have put those, like, higher as well. These are all crazy. And they all have different... tags.
I was gonna say the same thing.
The top
yeah,
as well.
They're
not
all,
just not just
all,
the name, but
yeah,
the sparkles. On
yeah,
them
and they're all different. Like, Looks like they're all angled differently too, almost in a sense.
These are these. I honestly like don't know if I can even like see myself wearing these.
Yeah.
But I needed them.
I could. Yeah, for sure. And like I said, even if you don't wear them, I mean, over time, like having the whole pack, and then over time just keeping them brand new, like I said, the value is probably gonna be insane on them.
I need to wear them, but I don't know. I just don't know. Like I don't know. We'll see.
Can we get a like a Maxwell Soles like type picture? Like
I was gonna do something today. Dang. I was gonna do something today.
That'd be insane.
I'm not quite as talented as Colby, but I will do my best.
That boy been inspiring me lately. I've been going.
First of all, he's good at what he does, but he's consistent, and that's so important. I want to take a picture of the Amine, but I just haven't had time. I'm gonna call it there. Next episode, we'll do the rest of the Nike Dunk collection, the non-SB versions. So this is part one of the collection video. To get the whole thing, it's probably gonna be 10 plus videos. But if everybody can agree next time, or if I get multiple, of insane, one thing, then Eli brought up a good one, which is Air Force Ones. I do have a good collection of Air Force Ones, so that'll probably be next.
Once again, like, just older stuff, like, that's what I like. It's just the older stuff, like, seeing SBs that you don't see every day, like, I don't see these every day, but, like, these come across me very frequently than, like, all the older stuff, like, even when I'm at the shop, like, and people bring older Jordans and stuff like that, like, stuff that we resonate with, I just truly enjoy that than seeing, something you see every day. You know what I mean? Like, me and a guy at the store was talking the other day, like, I get so excited when somebody picks, like, one random good shoe that we only have one size in, like, that might be an older pair or whatever. I get more excited having an interaction with that customer and buying the shoe and how much they've been wanting it and everything like that, then let me just get white Supreme Forces or...
Mm-hmm. Oh, I understand. So. My customers that come in and ask me if we have Jordan 4s, I already know you didn't research anything. I know you don't really know what you're talking about, and that's fine. Ignorance isn't a bad thing, but I'm definitely going to be more excited about the person that has already... They know what they're coming in for, and they want the... Maybe not the ASICs, because the ASICs, this trend is I'm not messing with y'all.
I was going to ask you about that, but I didn't want to get into it on this episode, because we're already...
Oh, y'all suck. Y'all are going to regret it. But, the people in the Vomero Wave is... I'm kind of almost in the same boat with the Vomero Wave, just the basic ones that are in store. Like, obviously, I love the Dornbecker ones, and I talked about that heavily last year, but maybe, the... Like, if a new Air Max comes out and they're excited to come get that, it's cool to have, genuine interactions.
I was going to say, the Carolina Blue Air Max 1 that y'all just got. Yeah. And, somebody might be an Air Max 1, head or, just that's their favorite shoe. So, every time a cool colorway comes out, they're going to get it. Same way.
I wanted to do Air Maxes for this episode, but I can't spoil what I have for y'all for the rest of the month. So,
that boy's been cooking on this, Air Max month.
This is day 18. I'll probably do something special on day 26, March 26, and I'll do something special on the last day.
Let's go.
Yeah, just trying to stay true to my roots, man.
True to this, not new to this.
Heat over height, I say that with my Powerpuff Girl SB collection.
Yeah, but you also just showed a 20 clip from 2006 and 2008, so, I mean, still... True to this, not new to this. Yeah. So.
But honestly, I don't really have that many more SBs that I want. There's only a few. There's only a few dunks that I want left in general. I could, if I had the money to buy, safe to say, 8 pairs, I'd be done for probably the rest of my life.
Yeah. I could relate to that for sure.
Be good. And that sounds like a lot to some people, but that, there's just certain pairs that I need in my collection.
Your 8 pairs that you just cap off and just say, all right, I'm done with this shoe, whatever.
If
and
then retails up here, it'd be crazy.
And then move on to your next one. You complete one set and you go on to your other one. So
yeah, I'm a set man. I need it. I need the packs. So
for sure.
I think that's it for episode 5 of Sole Sanity Sneaker Podcast. I appreciate everybody tuning in. I do have something coming today. I don't know when this episode will be out. But everybody, just stay tuned to the Instagram, and the ambassador's Instagram, and the podcast Instagram, and my Instagram. You know, everybody just stay tuned. Shop at soulsanity.com. Link in the bio. You know, use your code, Eli Dougie, with two E's. I appreciate all the support. You know what I'm saying? Make sure you subscribe. Like, comment, subscribe. We need it. We're only at 72 subs, bro. What's going on, bro? What's going on? I got more than 72 friends. He's got more than 72 friends. Come on. What's going on? Shout out UTNG. My man is Meso. Even though he's leaving. He's not leaving him, but he's stepping down, you know, making my job a lot harder. Forced me to go out and hire people. It's besides the point. I appreciate y'all. Like, comment, subscribe.
We appreciate the ones that are supporting consistently.
Like, comment, subscribe.
Everybody that's supporting consistently with the website, the podcast, the Instagram, YouTube, everything, we appreciate it for real.
Just watch the video. Watch it again. Go back and watch season one. Put it on when you go to sleep. Put it on in the car. Just leave it on. You don't even got to watch it.
Yeah. That's all we need.
All right. I'm Spence.
Hey, Doug.
Peace.
You good, T-Minus?
Niggas been counting me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading my clips, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit, the real ones been dying, the fake ones is lit, the game is off balance, I'm back on my shit, the Bentley is dirty, my sneakers is dirty, but that's how I like it, you all on my dick.